Hey everybody, I hope everybody's doing good out there. I'm back with another video for the Pod HD series. Now, I've been having emails for years, people saying, well, the pod sounds great connected to my computer and it sounds great with headphones, but when I hook it up to my amp, I can't get it to sound good. And I agree, it is difficult. I mean, you can't do it right out of the box, that's for sure. You've got to do a lot of tweaking. So that's what this set of patches is all about. Now, these particular patches are optimized to run into the front of a clean channel amp, or if you have an amp that has an effects loop, you can run it to the effects return of that amp. So basically, you're using the amp as a clean power source for the pods. Now, these sounds are for the new Pod HD500X, the Pod HD500, the Pod HD Pro X, the Pod HD Pro, and the Pod HD Bean desktop unit. Now, if you go to download these patches, inside the download pack, I'll have a PDF that's going to explain a few very important things. One is the output mode. It's got to be set right. Now, for these particular patches, I've set it on combo front. And with that, you get a global EQ, a low and a high and a mid focus. Comes in very handy. You're gonna need that. But anyway, I have this PDF. It's got pictures and it's got all my settings and everything for the output mode. Once you have that set, you can run these patches through anything. I've run them through 3 or 4 amps already. To the front, they sound great. And to the effects loop, effects return of 2 different amps I've tried them with so far, and they sound great. Now, I've also included 4 patches for you guys that play in a church setting. I get emails all the time, when am I going to come out with some patches for people that play in church setting with Hillsong music and things like that? Well, I got some in this pack. At the end of the video, I'm going to do a little bit short segment to let you hear how those particular patches sound in with some backing tracks, this little thing I put together, and I hope you like it. Now, I want to let you know and I want to stress that the signal chain is simple. Guitar into the pod, pod left mono output into the front of my clean channel amp or the effects return up of my amp. I'm miking it with an SM57, and I've got a little sound baffle around the back of the mic to cut down on the room noise, because it bothers me when I watch videos and you can hear the pick sound of the guitar. I really don't like that. I want you to hear just the amp and what these things sound like. And I'm not using any studio trickery, by the way. I've been accused of that. Nope, I'm going to play them right in front of you. You can hear them, and what you hear is what you get. There's no Pro Tools trickery. I'm not using any post, EQ, reverb, or delay. Any reverb and delay you hear is right in that patch. That's it. Very simple. I have no reason to trick you guys. You know, I want you to get the sounds that I'm getting. That's the whole purpose of me doing this, okay? So let's take a walk into my studio and I can demo these sounds for you. Okay guys, so here we are in my studio. This is where I do all of my work, my videos and video editing, all my recording for all my albums. And now for this demo, I'm gonna play each one of these patches twice. Once through the front of a clean channel amp, and for this, I'm gonna use my Dr. Z Mass 38. It has a really crystal clean channel. You're gonna need that if you're gonna run through the front of the amp. The pod has all the distortion and everything in it, so you need a clean channel amp. Now, if you're going to run through an effects loop return, any amp that has an effects loop will work. For this demo, I'm going to use this Trainer YCS50. Now, both of these amps have vintage Celestion 30s in them, so that's the speaker. And as far as miking it, I'm going to use this SM57 with this little sound baffle. I'm just going to put it right in front of the speaker, just like that. Plain and simple, right into my computer audio interface. So that's the signal chain. I'll be using a couple of different guitars. Maybe a Strat and Paul Reed Smith, I guess, just to give you a little variety. Now, I've left you room on these patches on the effects blocks. You got 8 effects blocks.
I'm only using three of them on the majority of these patches, and one of them is a volume pedal. Now, you really don't need that. There is a trick that I figured out where you can use the output of the amp and assign it to the expression pedal, and it'll act as your volume pedal. So if you need all your effects blocks, you can get rid of that one. I did a whole video on that. If you're interested, you can check it out. So anyway, now I'm going to start playing all the sounds, and I'm going to start with the Dr. Z, so let's get to it. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, well that's it guys. I've gone over all 20 patches with both of these amps here so you can kind of get a good idea of what they sound like. I thought it would be a good idea to end the video with a piece of music that I put together. It's real short and it'll give you a chance to hear what these might sound like in a mixed recording. So I'm going to end the video with that. Before I leave you guys, I want to again thank you for all of your continued support for my music and my YouTube channel. And as I've said before, I really enjoy talking with all of you guys from all over the world. I try to answer your questions if I can. But anyway, just a big thank you. You know, you guys rock so much. I really appreciate your support. So until I see you next time, I hope you enjoy these patches and hope you enjoy this little ending segment of music I put together. Until next time, guys, rock on.